McClunky.
Hello everyone and welcome to Dexter's Diner. Today we will be talking about the Count Dooku fight from episode 2, Attack of the Clones. And how is it truly amazing and the really good connection that it has with Duel of the Fates. But first of all, let's talk about Count Dooku. Now, in my opinion, Count Dooku is a great villain. We don't see him actually until the middle of Attack of the Clones, and he's also played by Christopher Lee, which adds that cool factor that he has. And the first thing that we see when we begin the duel is that he has a different lightsaber, a more inverted hilt, which makes him much different from all the Jedi and Sith. Another thing that we see him do is use Force Lightning, and at that point we have only seen Palpatine use Force Lightning, and he was very powerful. That tells us that Dooku is also pretty powerful if he can use Force Lightning. And also he is a rogue Jedi, something that we don't see that often. But nowadays this is pretty often, but back then this was the first time that we've seen a rogue Jedi, except I guess Anakin. So let's begin with the duel. First of all, the choreography is standard. All the prequel fight, or all the prequel movies have amazing choreography and visuals. And that is seen here with the lightning, and but not much. So the big connection with Duel of Fates that it has is seen in the beginning. Now, if you remember in Duel of Fates, which is a fantastic duel, I will probably make a video about that. One of the best ones there, but the real connection here is in the beginning. Where in Duel of the Fates, our characters were cut off by the ray shields. And Obi-Wan was nervous. He was stressed. He wanted to help Qui-Gon, but he was behind. Qui-Gon was the wise one, started meditating, waiting for the ray shields to open, and Darth Maul was just waiting there. He was waiting for the fight to begin. Now, in this one, it is very similar. This time, Anakin is the stressed one. He doesn't want to fight Dooku. He wants to get back to Padme, who fell out of that gunship while they were chasing Dooku. This time, the Obi-Wan is the wise one. Obi-Wan is calm, and he easily blocks Dooku's lightning, which Anakin falls for. He just runs and doesn't realize that Dooku can use Force Lightning, and he has been told that he is a powerful Jedi. He basically was the master of Qui-Gon, and Anakin knows that Qui-Gon was pretty powerful, as that was the first Jedi that he ever met. And Count Dooku in this situation is Darth Maul. He's waiting for the fight, he knows the fight is inevitable, and he knows that he will easily defeat Anakin, as he can see that he's stressed, and Obi-Wan alone will be easy, as Obi-Wan is still a Jedi Knight. He isn't a master yet, he's a fantastic swordsman, but he even says that he disappoints him.
Master Kenobi, you disappoint me. Yoda holds you in such high esteem. Surely you can do better.
Which, that's typical Sith talk, but Yoda segment is another great part of this duel, and I think it still holds up to this day. The CG doesn't look that bad, and I think it's really nice to see how Yoda actually fight with a lightsaber. This and the Darth Sidious duel is the only time we actually see Yoda fighting on the screen. We of course see it in the Clone Wars, and this was brand new. I mean, I would have never expected to see Yoda fighting, and I think it's really nice to see how he would fight with a lightsaber. He uses the first form, I believe. Yes, he uses the first form of lightsaber, of the lightsaber dueling style, I guess you could call it that. And, you know, originally I thought, you know, people thought probably that Yoda would basically use the Force to fight, as he has a full speech about the Force in Empire Strikes Back. And no, he actually uses a lightsaber, something, as I said, not expected. And another thing about this duel is that it is one of the shortest duels, if not the shorter one, the shortest one to be put on the screen. It's about 2 minutes with the Yoda duel, or 3 minutes. It's, as I said, pretty short, and, you know, I think this is a really good duel. In Attack of the Clones, we don't see much lightsaber combat, lightsaber dueling, so this is very nice to see, and it is one of the few times that we actually see Dooku fighting, as the other time is in Revenge of the Sith, which is also a very short duel. And that's really it for this video. If you guys enjoyed, I will be doing video essays like this weekly, and also I will be having a podcast on the weekends with my friend and other people. So thank you very much for watching, and if you like these types of video, be sure to subscribe, and so see you guys later. Bye.